In principle, turning old prints made of thermoplastics into raw material from a direct granule printer now works quite well. In this video I would like to introduce the mill I modified for this purpose and address the remaining weak points. The whole thing is based on a device that is advertised by the manufacturer as a grain mill and is similar in principle to the blender that I presented in the first video of this series. Instead of the plastic container, a stainless steel pot encloses the rotating blade. The motor is screwed on the steel pot, which makes the whole machine much more sturdy. The motor has an impressive output of 3.7 kW and the pot has a nominal capacity of 2500 grams. Such grinders are available in different sizes and price ranges, but in principle the following applies. More solid and more powerful is always better. Another point to keep in mind for a long service life that I mention with any machine is, never operate in the up to range. Since the mill does not have a built-in speed controller, I'm using an external solution. This power controller can handle 4 kW in continuous operation and therefore just fits the motor of my mill. The 10,000 watts printed on it is marketing bait, as it is only permissible for a short time when the machine starts up. It is a cheap product that comes out of the box without protective earth. I implemented those highly recommended extra wires in the plug and socket. When it comes to self-protection, one positive thing about the mill is that a switch ensures that the blade cannot start when the lid is open. The rubber seal reliably holds the powder inside the pot. The only modification I made was to install a sieve with an outlet in the front wall of the pot. The 3mm holes for screwing the parts as well as the cut into the 1.5mm thick stainless steel sheet were made with a Dremel. I showed how to make the sieve with the 1.9mm hole in a video about my spark erosion machine. The outlet was made with a 3D printer. While the white parts were made from PETG using a filament printer, the brownish parts are made from recycled PLA with my direct granule printer. A magnetic filter is integrated into the outlet to extract iron particles. As mentioned in previous videos, when grinding a material, the grinder itself is always ground as well. The chips from the blade and other metal parts from inside the pot would clog the printer nozzle. Since I process failed prints or various evolutionary steps of my projects in the mill, it can happen that a nut or screw ends up in the grinder. These chips should not get into the printer either. The ground material is collected in a dust-tight glass container that is attached to the outlet. Do not fill in too much material and make sure that the parts lie loosely on top of each other, otherwise the blade will stall when the engine revs up. The temperature of the pot is initially 13 degrees Celsius, which corresponds to room temperature. The power regulator is at level 14 of 22 when switched on. Even with this reduced power, there is a noticeable jolt when the machine starts up. The grinding process is very loud and you can hear the bangs and see that there is a jolt going through the grinder whenever a larger part is broken by the blade. The power is reduced even more after starting the mill and during the grinding process. As already mentioned in the first video, the mechanical power of the rotating blade is converted into heat. For the reasons mentioned, the grinder should not run for too long without cooling. I set the timer to 2 minutes and during this time the 300mm jar gets about 2/3 full of powder. The temperature of the pot has risen to 25 degrees Celsius on the outer wall. Allow a cooling period of 5 to 10 minutes before the next filling. In a quarter of an hour, significantly more raw material can be obtained than my printer can process in the same time. The yield here is 188 grams. The second material that I process in the mill is PETG. Personally, I can live with the grey, brown, greenish tone that you get if you don't sort by color. However, if you only put red material in, you'll also end up with red powder. PETG can also obviously be processed well with the mill, with the material throughput being roughly the same as that of PLA. However, some of the quite large PETG parts were printed with 100% infill, resulting in very solid bricks. At some point, the upper plate of the grinder gave up and crumbled. I didn't notice this immediately, but only after opening the lid. The magnetic filter did a great job keeping the metal chips away from the final product in the glass. Scratches on the wall of the pot show what raw forces are at work inside the mill. The sieve also suffered from the blows and in one spot it now has an overly large hole. A quick repair makes it possible to grind a few more portions of orange PLA. Now that the mill's weak points are known, it is time to finish upgrading my EDM machine to make a new, sturdier sieve and experiment with different blade geometries. In addition to further information about the project, you will also find a donate button on my website, which you can use to increase my motivation to continue working on the topic of plastic recycling and 3D printing. Many thanks to my anonymous major sponsor and all the other great people who have already made use of it. Thanks for watching and I'll be back.